Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to my corner of the internet. My name is Jason, and today we're playing some Arma 3. I'm going to call this one Operation Warfare because that's kind of what I'm trying to sort of simulate. In this episode, we are tackling... Let's let that load in. This will say 1 square kilometer area, and more specifically, there is a military base up on the hill here, and that's what we want to sort of capture to be able to secure that sector. We have, we'll say, equal number of forces, roughly. I use a point system to sort of balance things out. And there's a little bit more detail on how I'm going ahead and I'm creating these missions or how this campaign will play out in part zero. So if you're interested in hearing about that, go ahead and check that out. So I'm going to try to, focus my, commentary, though, on what's going on here. I have access to, I've got an APC behind me. So that will be coming along to aid in, the siege. I've also got access to a UAV for reconnaissance. And I've also got a guy set up for a mortar. Also, we do have, air support in the form of an attack chopper should the need arise. So, with that said, we're going to be basically sort of heading up north towards the, towards the objective. And, trying to take that. The enemy, their composition is, they probably have a slight advantage, in that they have, just due to their position, they've got more, adjacent areas, and they can call in air support from, their airfield, off to the east, so, we've got to be careful and, vigilant, keep an eye on the skies, that we don't get, bombarded without even realizing what hit us. Fortunately, the weather forecast says things are about to get, they're gonna get pretty foggy, so I'm hoping that will help, cover our movements. Looks like, some of our friendly forces got a head start on us, so we're gonna go ahead and, catch up with them. Okay, in my ear off to the right, I hear something. It sounds like a jet engine. Which makes me nervous because we have our APC. Where's our APC? I'm hoping the APC's in the buildings or around the buildings because I don't want it getting taken out by a rocket strike, it being a jet, it's more likely going to be a missile. But yes, that's right, because rockets are basically dumbfire, and typically missiles are more guided. Okay, I don't see it. And the sound seems to have gone away, so it probably passed over a different part of the map. But we do know that they have a jet in the air now, so we're gonna have to keep an eye out. One of the variables other than various troop composition and positions is that the enemy may have armor or also an attack chopper. So, that's fun as well. I've gotta keep an eye out for that. Oh, there's that sound again. I'm sure you can hear it now. Now it's loud. Oh, there it is. And we don't have any reported, fixed-wing aircraft in the area, so we know for a fact that that is op four. As infantry, we're not that afraid of it. But if our APC is caught out in the open, that could end poorly for him. Oh, I hear a chopper. Let's actually head for the trees. We're way out in the open, and there's a chopper. That's a good way for us to get mowed down. Okay, taking a second to breathe. This is basically where our troop positions currently are. So we're kind of behind the pack, to be very honest. We got quite a few guys up a little bit more along the roads. I decided to sort of split the forces and kind of come up the hill from different sides, because I feel that that's probably the better way to do it. What I'm going to do, though, is when I get close to the hill, is maybe pull out the UAV, try to get as close as I can, and try to get, enemy positions, and then call down mortar strikes on them, and then that might help with, the sieging of the hill, because this is not going to be an easy fight. Oh yes. I don't know if yes, there we go, yes! Number 7, okay, so our good shot, number 7. Or whoever was the gunner, 6 was the gunner. So our APC actually managed to somehow take out the jet. Okay. Good job, jet. Flying low and slow. Made for some easy shooting. So that means that all we have to worry about now is the chopper. If we can take the chopper out of the air, then that will make our approach to the tower all the, we'll say, easier. And then that will, I think that's basically what the plan is going to be. I'm going to try to take my team, because I hear the chopper, I know that they have a chopper. We're going to try to take that chopper out of the air. Then we can approach the hill without being, without them having air superiority. And then we can go ahead and mortar, we'll say, the positions that the, holy crap, what the heck?
Report position.
I'm right here. Okay, okay, what the heck?
Gunship, 1.5 clicks. North.
Go, I'll cover.
Okay, we're out in the open and they're calling out a gunship. Okay, I'm getting to a building. Move to cover, move to cover. Okay, I don't know what the heck just happened. I just know that I think that was our APC return fire on something. Or was it an initiated fire? I don't know. Although, wait, that's right. Seven called out the gunship. So, Evans, number four, he's our, I don't know if he's... Oh, crap. I don't know if he's AT or AA. He's probably AT. Well, okay, well, we'll try. I'm going to assign him the target of the Cashman.
Four, attack that gunship. Grid 120. 1-6-6.
I'm trying to get a visual. I don't know where it is. Where is it, actually? It says, bearing. Bearing 330. Let's take a look at... Okay, so the chopper is actually over in that direction. Okay, yeah, that matches up where the APC was shooting. So, let's, yeah. I'm gonna have to get on the other side of this, this building to be able to hit it, but... we know where the chopper is now. We got a bearing, and I'm gonna see if maybe our rocket guy can take it out of the air. That would be nice, because like I was saying, then once we can we'll say maybe mortar or take out their air defenses, then I can call in our own chopper to you know, give us some air superiority. Holy crap! Okay, I think the gunship knows that we have the APC, and it's firing at the APC. Ooh. I really hope we don't lose our APC. That would suck. That would definitely, we'll say, be unfortunate. I'm gonna have to stay low to the ground here. Yeah, I don't want to poke my head up right now. Gunships are definitely a lot more, we'll say, a lot more dangerous to infantry than, we'll say, a fixed-wing aircraft. Like, the chopper's a lot more dangerous than that jet was to us. Oh man. I hope we can take that out, because that's gonna be a major hurdle for us. Where are our buddies? We have... Okay, now, it's not updating our friends on our map based on where they actually are. It's just updating it based on where their last position was. It's kind of like, basically visual cues, so I don't know exactly where they are. But what I'm going to do is, because the way I set this up, because I can switch to any other party member, listen to me. It's not an RPG, Jason. I'm going to hit U, which is going to bring up this menu. And that way there, I'm going to be able to see, okay, where's Alpha 1-2? And it's going to be able to show me on the map where they are. Well, what about 1-3? Well, okay, they're already up in enemy territory. Actually, I think I see the helicopter up there. What about this team? So we have some teams definitely ahead of us. I'm hoping maybe that they'll take out the chopper before we even get there. But if they don't, then that's going to be really crappy, because they're probably going to get mowed down in the process. Which is definitely, you know, something we don't want. So, I'm going to keep my head down, because I don't know. I don't know exactly the range of that thing. I don't know. It's probably got, like, thermal vision. It's probably got thermal sighting, right? So, it can see me probably better than I can see it. Especially as the fog rolls in. Yeah, maybe relying on the fog to be, we'll say, my friend in this engagement was not the, it's not gonna work out as much as I would hope it would've. Okay. Yeah, I'm not going to go that way. It's obvious that it's got some lines of fire there, so we're gonna creep around this side here. Hello, chopper? Yeah, okay, I hear fighting ahead of me. We're gonna maybe cut through this way. Yeah, there's definitely some fighting going on up ahead. We'll say behind the pack, but the fact that I'm still able to take fire this far back, I don't know if it's necessarily a good thing or a bad thing that I'm back here. Okay, I'm stuck in. Oh no, there's a wall around this sort of cemetery, and that's gonna put me right out in the open if I go through this opening right here. Oh crap! Is that getting closer? I think that chopper's getting closer. Oh crap, I'm getting down. Don't move. Don't move. Wait. Oh, I missed the whole thing. I was looking in the wrong direction. We shot the thing down. Yes! Awesome. Okay. This is a good development. I think the thing maybe came in for an attack run, but our vehicle and actually let's see that was 7. So that was our APC that dropped it. Nice.
Area clear.
Awesome. So everybody join up on me. Yeah, so I suppose that does make sense, that sentence. Anyways, now that they don't have their own chopper, I want to get in close. And I want to start shelling the hill. Can I even see the hill from here? Let me see. We are here. Oh, it's a little bit over in that direction. So maybe I'm hooking a little bit too west. I'm gonna start taking this road here. Yeah, I can see the hill off in the distance. Now the fog is starting to get a little bit, we'll say, heavy. So it's definitely, we'll say, limiting visibility. I need to actually stop. My guys are way behind. I need them to catch up before I make any more movements forward, because I'm one guy out in the middle of the street here. Not a good place to be. Okay, guys, come on, join up. Yeah, just stand in the middle of the street. That's cool. I suppose I have them set at aware mode, so it's not a huge. It's to be expected that that's how they would behave. Alright, so there's still some fighting going on, we'll say, to the north, so. Let's hurry up and catch up with the rest of the team. Okay, there's a lot of shooting off to my left, so let's say a little bit more off to the west. And that's where some of our friendly forces are likely engaging some of Op4's, maybe we'll say, sentries. Basically, I didn't tell them to just sort of sit in their base and wait for us to attack. You know, they've moved some troops out of their base to sort of, we'll say, ambush positions, if you will, so that way they're, they can get to us before we can even get to the hill. Yeah, there's some explosions and stuff going over there. I'm wondering if we should assist our we'll say friendlies, and then move up to the hill together. That might not be a bad idea. Rather than just hitting the hill directly. We can go up with them and hit that. And actually, that's right. That's something I forgot. The hill's actually got two tall guard towers on it, and there's a possibility that they'll have like gun emplacements up there, like a 50 cal up on top of the tower. So, yeah, we'll move over this way and see if. We can't, group up with some of our friendlies and help them out with whatever it is that they're trying to handle. Okay, so it seems I actually just sort of did a quick checkup on, the other fire teams, the other squads, and it looks like basically everybody who went to the east got just totally wiped out. So we've taken some heavy losses. I definitely want to move, we'll say northwest. And whoa, help out those guys over there. Crap. Those are whizzing right past my head. Everybody, get down.
Rifleman, 800 meters, northeast.
Northeast, okay, so that's over in that direction. Okay, now I know where the fire's coming from. See, I knew bullets were, whizzing past me, but I didn't know from where. Okay.
Soldier.
Okay, is that coming up from the hill? Oh man, they're actually hitting me from the hill. Okay, what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna get 8 to, see, basically this is showing, we'll say an approximate, we'll say location they could have moved from here. But what I'm going to do
It's not clear.
You get your butt down. Get it down.
2, 3, 4. Danger.
Actually, for that matter, you guys, you need to be in a danger mode as well.
Soldier, 800 meters, northeast.
All right.
6, 5. Get ready.
All right.
Requesting support. 8.
Grid. I'm calling 8 to drop some, to basically fire off some mortars. So, there, we'll get him to, fire
requesting
artillery
support.
There.
8. Grid 1, 2, 7. 1, 6, 6.
And then maybe some here.
Requesting support. 8. Grid 1, 2, 7. 1, 6, 6.
And let's see. Let's listen. I don't really have a good visual, but we should be able to hear it when the mortars hit. Oh, there we go, over there. One down. I'm waiting for the other rounds to hit. Okay, that one was not a hit.
Area clear.
Alright, I'm actually going to bombard the hill a little bit more. Right here in the center of the, we'll say, the military base itself, I'm actually going to get 8 to maybe fire off a burst of 4.
Sit rep. Requesting support. 8. Grid 1, 2, 8.
Crap.
One, six,
I think 4 is dead.
We got a man down. Round's complete.
Alright, I think now it's time to call in the UAV to sort of, we'll say, check our approach here a bit. I don't know where. Okay, I'm gonna send the UAV over this way here.
9. Move to grid 1, 2, 0. 1, 6.
Man,
three.
He says that with some real oomph. Okay, there we go. I'm bombarding. You know what? No. Maybe we should try. I don't know if we can fire artillery that accurately. I was like, maybe if we can hit the towers. Let me see. I don't know if there's anyone currently up. Wait, I think I see someone standing. So yeah, we do have people up on that tower. Up on the towers. Wait, I can call, I can call in air support, but what if they shoot down the air? Okay, I'm doing it. Actually, give me a second. I'm going to, let's open the UAV terminal. I want to see. We're gonna jump over to this view. Where are we at? Going to thermal. I don't really see anything. I don't know exactly where we're located, so maybe it's not the best. Let me actually release. Let me see. Where is it at? So this is where the darter is right now. That's where its current position is. So if I can jump back over to the we'll say the gunner position, that's where I can sort of just look around. I want to be looking a little bit more. Bit northeast, so around in that direction over there. Yeah, that's where the hill is. Cam magnification. Can I increase that? Because I don't really feel like I can really see what I'm looking at here. Okay, that's laser. I don't want to put down a laser designator. That's something I've got to work into. We'll say some later missions. So yeah, the fog is making it really hard to see anything. I can't see anything from here. I'm gonna have to definitely tell Buddy to maybe move up a little bit closer, but I don't want to lose my UAV. So we see that we have a friendly up here. Okay. 9, can you maybe... I'm gonna lose the UAV, I just know it. I just need confirmation that there are people on the people on those towers, and then maybe I can see if get basically a mortar marksman to see if he can basically fire and hit. that's a little bit ridiculous, maybe, but all right. I figured out how to use the zoom, so as soon as we sort of level out, I'm going to try to zoom in on those towers. I need you to, yeah, come on, just angle up a little bit more so I can sort of zoom in. I can't really get a good view. UAV, stop moving! Okay, we definitely have- yeah, there's a gun up on the tower. There looks like to be- there's two sentries. Okay, so I count for that. Okay, you know what? Get out of there. 9.
Move to grid 1-1-0-1-5-5.
Yeah. We've got a man down.
No. Okay, they took out the UAV, but I've got some positions. So we've got guys here. Oh man, they're moving up on us. You know what? Screw hitting the towers. 8. I need an artillery strike. We'll say burst
requesting
3 here.
Support. 8. Grid 1. 2-4.
Hopefully that'll slow or stop their advance a bit. 7, where are you at? Are you with us yet? No, you're not. I'm still waiting for the APC to catch up. He's probably stuck on a rock. Okay, I'm gonna move over a bit here. Wait for the artillery to hit, and then I can maybe, look around. I can't even tell where that hit now.
10. Sit rep.
No. Okay, 10, that was just the UAV, so yeah. We already know he went down.
We got a man down.
So we lost the UAV. Crap. Okay, it's hitting nearby. I can't see him though. I don't know where anyone's at. Okay. You're calling out guys at 045. They're all bearing 045, so that is...
What's your position?
You know, we need air support. I don't know if they've got anti-air, but we need air support at this point. What I'm gonna do is I'm also going to, maybe 8, can you try? Just try your absolute best. Maybe drop a mortar shell right here!
Requesting support. 8. Grid one,
that would be very helpful if you could do that for us.
Six.
Round's complete.
Yeah, because we're actually in a bad spot. We are losing this. We are losing this fight. Assaulting a target is always difficult, especially if now that I think about it, especially considering we have, we'll say, like even numbers. Because if you want to have a reasonable chance of success, you really want to have, we'll say, greater numbers when assaulting a target. Did it hit? No, I hit beside it. Darn it. Hey, 8, can you try that again? It's repeat artillery fire.
Requesting support. 8, grid 1-2-2-1-6-2.
Round complete.
So wait. 1-2-2. No, not on my position! Did I accidentally tell him to fire on my position? I think I did. Run! Buddy, I called in artillery on us. Get out of the way! No! Come back!
Fire. Do not fire.
When I said repeat, I thought he would just do the last fire mission. Okay, I hear.
Target neutralized. Hostile down.
Okay, they're shooting from over in that direction. I wonder if they're firing on the chopper. I see some smoke over there. I don't know what's causing that. Maybe a rocket? I'm not sure what our chopper was able to do, if anything. Okay, let's try this again. Now that we've learned that, we'll say, because when I hit, it says repeat artillery fire. I thought that just meant, you know, repeat the last thing you did.
8, grid 1,
good thing, I'm glad I paid attention to the grid coordinates that my guy gave, though.
Over.
Oh. 2's down now. Crap. Come on, miracle mortar. You can do it. Miracle mortar. You can do it. Yes! Yes! Holy crap! The whole thing went down! That was beautiful! Beautiful! Mwah! Alright. Well, on that note, hey, let's try hitting the other one. You know what, just, buddy? Just try a burst of 2.
Requesting support. 8. Grid 1. 2-7. 1-6-7.
Oh, man. That was some precise hitting. Well, I don't know. Is that realistic? And maybe anyone who's a little bit more familiar with, we'll say, how well you can be with, we'll say, targeting with mortar. I would think you'd have like the one shot, and then you'd have to be like, okay, correct by this. Yep. Bam. Bam. Their guard towers are down. I'm going to have a fun time in the editor trying to make sure that those things are dead in the next mission. Because that's one thing I want to do, is I want to have persistence, right? So if they expend some of their points to purchase fortifications and stuff, I want those to persist in the next map. But on the same note, I also want things that are destroyed to stay dead. Oh, okay, where is that fire coming from? 045, we have a marksman at 045 from us. Let me see, that is over by where the 8 is? Let me see. Yeah, right about here. And I don't see him. Is he on the other side of that bush? The brush? Okay, 7, where are you at?
7, fall back!
Copy!
Yeah, get close to me. Cause I really don't have anyone with me. I've got, Burr, who's my grenadier, and I have no idea where he is. He appears to be missing! Okay, I am really on my own here. Crap, we'll say, with as much damage as I've kind of been able to inflict, I don't think we're ultimately going to win this one. Alright, checking the sit rep on, you'll say, the other teams. We have some that are a little bit further back. They've probably gotten torn up. And we've got a couple guys up to, we'll say, our north. And those were some of the teams that I was going to have, we'll say, hook around. I'm thinking maybe I'll join up with them and maybe just help them out in the fight, because rather than letting them try to sort of fend for themselves and then join up with us later to attack, I think that if I could, we'll say, catch up with them and bring the APC along, that we can, you know, sort of push through together. Although I'm wondering where 7 is. 7, why are you so far away from me? Let me check my map. Where is he at?
600 meters, northeast.
I can't see anything. There's no visibility. And now it's raining, so things are going to get even worse. Okay, I need to get out of the open here.
400 meters, northeast.
Oh, crap.
400 meters, northeast.
Okay. So there were some enemies over there, and I detected them, and my APC decided, don't worry, boss, I've got you covered. Thank you, APC guy. That was definitely... it's startling, right? Everything's quiet, and then all of a sudden I hear, dong, 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 dong. Yeah, that kind of sound, except much closer. Alright, so it's amazing, this entire fight has taken place almost entirely in our own territory. 3, I actually need you to maybe switch over to aware, just so you can catch up.
3, stay sharp! Contact, 600 meters, north.
North? Like, straight north? How do I see this? Like, the character that is me in this game just has this amazing eyesight, like, he could see through his ears, that was completely off to my left. Now there are two... Wait. Okay. I think that might have been just some of my aliased grass that was making it look like there was something over there. It's impossible to see. You know, I thought fog would be cool, but it is cool, but it's also not cool. I suppose, like, it works both ways, right? It gives me some cover while moving, but at the same time, it's very, it hinders your movement, it slows you down a lot, because you can't just, it's harder to check your surroundings. And then, you know, you're out in the middle of the field, and then all of a sudden the fog decides to lift, and you're like, ah! And you're caught out there with your pants down, and then things get really awkward. And by awkward, I mean terrible, because you end up wanting... Well, not wanting to die, you end up dying. Okay, let me take a look. Wow, we are so chewed up. Okay, there are guys to our left. There's one guy off to our east. I want to just say, no, guys, this is a wash. We can't take this, and then leave, and then, you know, grab a few, we'll say, of the bonus points for, we'll say, having surviving members. But at the same time, there's a little part of me that's going, you know, we might still be able to do this. You know, we might, just might be able to still do this. And my map has got no info.
Right, 400 meters, bearing 045.
Target's down!
But then again, this APC seems to have been, we'll say, traveling along with us fairly, actually, fairly unmolested. Is that the proper way? I think that's the proper way to use the word, right? I think so. Anyways, that might be my key to victory here, is having this guy move on. Maybe it's good that I kept it sort of in the rear, and now it's unfortunate, you know, that a lot of the infantry got chewed up. But having it along to mess everyone up after they've been weakened, and you know, maybe they've expended a lot of their rockets and stuff, we still have this nice big gun to sort of equalize the playing field for us. Yeah, we're gonna try it. We're gonna fight to the bitter end. We're gonna fight to the death. We're gonna try to take that hill.
Scratch one.
Oh, nailed him! I thought I saw something move over there, so I was like, let's go ahead and drop a mortar over there. And sure enough, we took a guy out. My APC should be fairly close to us now. Oh, my map apparently shows that there's another one right there. I don't think I'll need to mortar that one though.
Target down.
Nope. I'm willing to bet. Yep, he's gone. All right, APC guy, you're a little bit closer.
Contact. Half a click east.
All right. I'm actually going to tell you to we'll say advance. I'm actually going to send the APC up ahead of us. Because if I just run through this field, I'm going to get smoked.
Soldier, half a click northeast.
So they're all over.
Soldier,
they're all around here. East. Okay, so we got a guy there moving. We also have a guy up over by the hill. So they're in this area here, and there's a guy over there as well. Possibly, it's kind of semi-transparent. We're gonna go ahead and just
support. Drop shells around
all over the place here.
Requesting support. 8, grid 1,
let's
two,
just bombard
five,
this place.
1, 6, 3. Requesting support. 8, grid 1, 2, 5.
One, there we go.
6, 5.
I think I've called
requesting
out enough locations.
Eight, grid 1, 2, 4. 1, 6, 5.
Now let's just let the mortar shells hit and hopefully
eight,
we'll hit something.
Grid 1, 2, 6. 1, 6, 4.
Come on.
Requesting support. 8, grid 1, 2, 5.
I hope he's got enough
one,
ammo for
six,
all this.
3. Requesting support. 8, grid 1, 2, 7. 1, 6, 5.
Where did that one hit? So, oh yeah, some are hitting over there. No positive hits. Oh, one over there.
We've got an enemy. Medic.
Oh!
Scratch one!
Nice, okay. Hopefully that will sort of get them suppressed. In this particular series, well, maybe not the series, because I can change that up between missions. That's the other nice, we'll say, benefit of doing things this way, is that if I make each individual mission, I can change mods up and stuff on the fly. For this first mission, I actually opted to try out the vanilla Arma 3 experience, because there was some different changes on the development build, and I wanted to get a feel of how we'll say suppression and stuff worked in the vanilla game, because apparently there've been some quote unquote improvements. I don't know, I haven't really noticed them yet, but there've been some improvements to, we'll say, AI and suppression. And while I haven't been able to test those myself because I haven't had a chance yet to fire on anyone, I figured I would try this, at least, we'll say, for this first episode, vanilla. So this is the vanilla Arma 3 experience, and actually, so far, things feel good. I don't feel like I feel like the AI is actually pretty competent, it's pretty good, and it's, I'm having fun with it. Okay, so he's slowly pulling out in front of us. Where is he? Oh, there he is. You know, what is this thing called? I keep calling it an APC, but I'd like to know what you actually are. I keep forgetting the name. It's, Seven? I don't know. It's something. It's cool. A marshal? I think that's what it was called. It's a marshal. Alright. Guy, you head on up and you kill anything you see. I'm moving up behind you. Number three, you should have been caught up with me by now. Are you injured? I think number three. Oh, there. Yeah, he does look like he's kind of hurt, though. Well, at least he can still walk. As long as his legs are still working, that's good. Oh, this is cool. I forgot that this vehicle worked through water, so we could actually maybe do a beach landing with some of these. Huh. I'm seeing some special forces operations in our future. Okay, that shot came. Well, at least it snapped over my head to the left. Now that you're with me, please go into combat mode. Okay, we've got this. Oh crap! That hit close. I saw the tracer on that one.
700 meters east.
That's up on the hill. All right. Yeah, we're gonna have to rely on the vehicle a lot for this. We'll say for this approach. Now, there hasn't been any rockets yet. Knock on wood, cross your fingers. And if they don't happen to have any rockets or anything, then we may just stand a chance. Now, since that thing does have wheels, it's not tracked, they could always take out the tires, so... like I said, I definitely do not want to get too cocky here. But, I think that as long as we have the, like I said, I think it's the marshal. As long as we have that thing, I think we have a chance. Oh, those shots are hitting close. Get behind this small little conveniently placed rock wall. Yes. And stay behind it. Hey, seven, or six, or whoever's, you guy. Vehicle guy. Can you maybe kill some of the people who are shooting at us? Like, I get that you might not have line of sight, but if you happen to have line of sight, I'd really appreciate it if you capitalized on that, took advantage of it and fired back. That would be great. Yeah, I would like that. Like, I'd like to fire back, but I don't know where the shots are coming from. I can't see anything. I almost feel like maybe the AI's not tweaked properly, because I'm like, the AI could see me, and it's able to fire on me, but I'm not able to see, so it's like, we'll say the player's visibility versus the AI's visibility is not, equal. Now, I don't know if that's just because my settings, I don't have the best computer, so things aren't, set up the best, graphical fidelity or quality, whatever, wise, but, surely, you'd want to work on maybe having that scale properly, that, the game would still be, we'll say, fair and playable even on lower settings. Yeah, trees in your way, just knock it over. Okay, we're taking lots of fire, I don't know if we're taking lots of fire, but I'm hearing lots of fire. No, that's right, if we were taking fire, we'd hear that high-pitched snapping sound. That's one thing I've got to say, even from when I played Arma 3 before to now, they've made some major changes to the way sound works, and I'm loving the sound design in this, the way things actually sound like they're off in the distance, and, the sound sounds a lot more realistic. I like the sounds of the guns, they just sound overall better. I know I haven't really had a chance to fire mine yet, I'm noticing a big improvement in the sound from when I first got into the game during the alpha. I don't see anyone. Oh, wait, I do see someone! I finally see somebody! Let's go ahead and deploy the gun. We're gonna rest the gun. That's... I don't know how far away that guy is, but...
Area clear.
I wanna say he's about, Oh yeah, there's a couple over there. I see movement. I definitely see movement, so...
Cover me! Reloading!
Yeah, that gun sounds good. Put some fire down on top of the hill there.
Riflemen! 400 meters southeast!
400 meters! Wait, southeast? Okay, so let's actually stop resting the gun, maybe reorient myself. North.
East.
300 meters! 300 meters east, east, east. That's this way. I don't see him yet. Sit up just for a second. I don't. I'm scanning. I don't see anything. I feel like I feel like when I first started playing Arma 2, like when I first got into the game, I had such a hard time with, we'll say, target acquisition because, you know, I wasn't used to these kinds of ranges. Because, you know, most shooters, you know, take place very close, and Arma's got these extreme ranges. You know, you're fighting hundreds of meters apart, and I remember I had a really hard time. I'm like, I can't see the enemy. I don't know where they're at. What the heck is going on here? And that's kind of how I feel right now with all this fog. There's like no visibility, and there's like no, no, 400 meters east. Take him out, please, kill him. That's our like one chance of winning. Is that the APC? Where is he at? I don't see him. Crap, I don't see him. Eight. Just mortar, fire.
He's down.
Okay, that's cool. Drop some mortars anyways.
1-6-4. Requesting support. 8. Grid 1-2-7. 1-6-4.
Just the case there too. All right.
Requesting support. 8. Grid 1-2-6.
Oh man, I don't know what I would have done without mortars, like without artillery in this mission. All right. I'm seeing. Like, I'm seeing, like, traces here and there. Okay, it's over there. Yeah, shots hitting close to me. So we're taking fire. I don't want to advance, but I want to advance. Eight. You need to do some more.
Requesting support. 8. Grid 1-2-6. 1-6-4.
Come on, 8.
Requesting support. 8. Grid 1-2-6. 1-6-4. Requesting support. 8. Grid 1-2-6.
What the heck?
6. 1-6-4.
Round complete.
Wait a second. I didn't call. Crap, I forgot. There's a possibility that the enemy has mortar. I put mortars up in the base. They might be
target
shelling us!
Target neutralized!
Holy crap! I forgot about that!
Soldier, 300 meters east!
So there's a possibility that the enemy's trying to mortar us, because those shots hit right next to us. And, okay, unless, I'll have to go back and look at the chat log and see, you know, if my guy, if I accidentally did what I did last time, you know, and I call it on our position. But I'm pretty sure I didn't do that. Like that shell hit close, right? That shook my screen. That was like right over here by, I think. Am I remembering wrong? Okay, you know, buddy, I'm gonna heal you up. There we go. Get him patched up so he's at least maybe able to shoot a little bit better. Because yeah, when you're injured, your gun is swinging all over the place.
Okay,
and, you know, he can't be effective like that. Alright, let's do this! Oh crap, let's not do this! No, don't do this! Stop shooting at me!
Rifleman,
you can't see me anymore, I am behind the bush, I don't exist! I am not here. Okay, there's a man due east. 300 meters away. Where at? Where are you?
I need some help here.
You got hit again? I just healed you. What was that? Was that shooting? That's I don't recognize that gunfire. There was that steady shooting, and I couldn't tell if that was coming from the APC or number three off to my I think he's off to my left. Is he off to my left? Is he off to my right? I don't know. Anyways, I couldn't tell where it was coming from. I don't know if it was maybe the enemy, but that sounded really close to be an enemy. That would have freaked me right out. Oh, that is interesting. You know, I thought something looked weird about the vehicle, but its tires have been taken out. But it's still driving. That is a definite change they've made to the AI. Typically, when the tires are taken out of a vehicle, the AI dives out. They get out and they proceed on foot. The fact that these guys are still pushing on without the tires means that they have definitely made some improvements to the AI. You know, the fact that the AI has not jumped out of the vehicle allows me to, we'll say, continue on with this mission. Oh, I see someone right up there. Crap. Hey, yo, buddy. Up on the hill. There was a guy running. You want to shoot him? No? Maybe? Yeah? You'll think about it. All right. I'll give you some time. But yeah, because, this mission could have been over a lot sooner had the AI decided, you know, we're gonna get out because, you know, we don't have any tires, so we're just gonna stop. So that is nice. I really like what Arma 3 is shaping up to be. It's awesome. It was awesome before, but now it's like it just keeps getting better and better and better and better. And I love this game. Yes, I love this game. I feel like we're so close, yet we can't quite make it because the vehicle's having such a hard time getting up the hill. And 3 is injured, and I'm just one guy. And I checked my the list here. And aside from, we'll say, one grenadier over here, who is, wait a second, who's in the military base? A guy's in there. We have a friendly in the base. Crap, I might have been shooting at him. Okay, I'm gonna run up into the, I'm torn. I'm like, do I just, I'm like, there's one friendly in there, so I want to run up there and be like, hey, we won. But at the same time, I'm like, watch, with my luck, I'm gonna start running up there, and then I'm gonna get killed on the way up the hill. Okay. No, I need to take this slow and be smart about this. Alright, I've made it into the base. Nothing happened, so I decided I'm pretty much just gonna cut that out. But I walked in, I cleared the area a bit, and, there is no one here. And evidently I did something wrong with my mission creation because I didn't get any, we'll say, mission accomplished. We'll say note, but we've gone ahead and we've looked around and there's nobody in here. So, I'm going to go ahead and count this one as a success. Yeah. Yeah, because there's nobody in the base.
I've got him.
Okay, but that puzzles me. I say there's nothing left, but 8 is saying he's neutralizing people. Who is he taking out? That tells me that there's still enemies out there that need to be, we'll say, dealt with. Like, we've got, wait. That's the crewman. You guys finally jumped out of the Marshall? Did the thing run out of gas? Did something happen? Like, I'm curious. Like, I'm really wondering why they the flag didn't trip. So it's making me wonder. You know, are there other, we'll say, op four out there that could come back and do a counterattack? You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna go to Zeus and I'm gonna take a look. And if maybe the AI is just hung up on one place, I need to give them new orders to come and attack us. Okay, so jumping into Zeus, we actually have, yeah, we've got a big squad right here, a lot of Op 4 sitting down here on the hill, as well as, we'll say, a team of Blue 4 that doesn't seem to be moving either. So, wait, team of blue force doesn't seem to be moving. That's me, you idiot! Oh, yes, right. So over here, there's some op force. So you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna highlight these guys, and I'm gonna give these guys the order to come in and attack us. That's it. And now, jump back over to us. We'll count this as a counter-strike, a counter-attack. I realize that I'm kind of cheating a little bit, in the sense that I know which direction they're coming from, and we're gonna be taking up defensive positions to, we'll say, defend against it. So that's a little unfortunate, but, hey, at least the fight's not quite over yet. And, you know, all the enemies, we will still get a chance to really, fairly take this place. Because technically we were not fighting against the entire team, so. And I'm wondering if that's what 8 has been taken out. I'm wondering if he's been hitting those guys over here, wherever they happen to be. Maybe I'm gonna try to get up on top of this structure. And see if I can get, some good lines of sight for the defense of this base. I feel bad for looking in Zeus, but it's obvious that the AI was messed up. And if I hadn't done that, then they wouldn't even be coming to attack us at all in the first place. So it is what it is. At least we're getting, we're making things fair. If they come in and they smoke us, then you know what? They've earned the right to defend this base. Just because I'm here doesn't mean that I should just declare myself the victor and then be like, oh, well, the AI screwed up. That's their own fault. No, no. They're going to come back and try to reclaim the base from us. I don't know where they're at, though. So maybe they'll surprise me. Maybe their approach will be, an interesting one. I'm getting really nervous because I'm not seeing them. I'm not hearing them. I'm just like, where are these guys? They're gonna surprise me, aren't they? They're gonna do something crazy. Like I said, Arma 3's been doing some stuff with, AI. I'm not sure to what extent. You know, they may have changed up some of the ways that the AI will behave, you know, while attacking and stuff. That's completely possible. You know, maybe it's all in my head. Or maybe they're just walking in a straight line to me, but just because I can't see them, my imagination is going absolutely wild. Oh man, I am like totally freaking out right now. I need to set up my guys in decent positions though. Maybe three
move up.
Roger three that. Move there. Maybe let's see, Davies, ready. Can you go over by that box?
Move half a click west.
Six.
Move
maybe
left.
Take up a position here. And I'll put maybe seven up here with me as well.
Waiting.
Wait, no. I don't want us all grouped everywhere, all together. So I'll put him over seven. Here by the concrete
move
barrier.
Right. On the way.
So I'll send those guys out to various. Wait, where are you going? Five? No. No. I meant like right here.
Five. Move up.
On the way. Waiting.
Yeah. And everybody, you know what? Everybody just go into, like, combat
get
mode.
Get set to engage.
Wait!
Get ready. We know something's coming. And they definitely have the number advantage. That's true. They do have the number advantage, don't they? What are you looking at? Why are you facing that way? Do you see something? Is there something I should know? Oh man, the tension is crazy. I just want to start dropping mortars all around the base. I'm like, oh man, you know what? They're probably surrounding us or something. Are they even moving? I don't want to check because then I'll spoil the surprise for myself if they are doing something crazy. If they don't show up soon, though, I'll give them a few more minutes. And if they don't show up, then I'll go take a look at Zeus again and see. What are you guys doing? Are you coming? And they'll be like, no. It's okay, you can have base. I'm like, oh, okay. Thanks, I guess. Oh, okay. I'm hearing fire. Okay, so it looks like they're coming from that entrance over there. But I don't want to get tunnel vision.
Medic,
100 meters! Front!
Okay, so those two are covering that side. I want to keep an eye over here just in case, but I don't want to get shot from the left. Anything over there? Oh crap, I can see them! Okay. Let's lean around a bit. Whoa, get down, get down!
Sniper, 100 meters front!
Alright, it begins! The fight for the base. He doesn't see me, but I see him. Oh no, I didn't hit. Oh, headshot! That's totally a headshot. Hey buddy, you got headshotted. That's right. Oh, yes. Okay, good.
Rifleman,
that's one guy down.
75 meters. Whoa.
Another one down. Yes. Oh, wow, there's... Oh, yes, reload while standing up. Please do. Thank you. Oh, another one got down. I'm feeling... Oh, no! I was just about to say, I'm feeling like Rambo. I died. And there's three of them coming in. Four of them coming in. Okay, team switch. I need to switch over to... over to this guy. Alright. Oh, crap.
Reloading.
I need to reload. They're coming. Oh, three is hurt. Oh, yeah, they're all on the other side of this wall, aren't they?
Rifleman, 75 meters, left!
Throw a grenade out. Have fun with that one, boys! Okay, this is great. Oh, this is good. Hello? Are you around this corner?
Soldier, 75 meters right.
Where's that fire coming from?
75 meters back.
Oh, from the back. Okay, so yeah, they're. Where's that fire coming from?
Stretch one. I got him.
Okay, he's up on the our friendly's up on the stairs, I guess.
Form on me. Three. Attack that sniper.
Come on, just. Get down, reload,
Target's down!
Wait, I've got a grenade, right.
Reloading!
Okay, that was cool, okay. Just gotta keep an eye out. There's probably more. We were vastly outnumbered.
Clear.
Really? Clear? Are you sure? Are you positive about that? I'm not so sure you're positive about that.
Report in. Over.
Okay, so six died. One died. That was me.
Man down. Eight. Form on me.
All right. So there's another one there. Are there more of them coming? Oh, that's awesome to see the destruction. You see the guy sitting in the debris from when we hit it with the mortar shell? Oh, great. You're just gonna stand out in the opening. You're just gonna do that. Okay. Yeah, you do that, guy. Okay, I haven't been attacked in a while, but the mission accomplished thing hasn't come up either yet, so... I'm really getting... nervous? Like, I don't remember, I wasn't counting how many we took down. Part of me wants to just go ahead and, like, check Zeus out and be like, alright, where are they?
Eight! Form on me! Three! Seven!
Wait!
Attack that rifleman! Southwest!
Where's that? Southwest!
Target.
Yes! It says mission accomplished! But we haven't taken this guy out yet, so... And now we have the end of the mission!
Got a man down.
Seven. I'm the new actual.
Wow. Talk about fighting down to the bitter end. Mission accomplished. All enemies neutralized. We've taken the base. Holy crap, let's take a look at the final unit count. We have a total of three people. The civilian is just my Zeus guy. We have a total of three guys, which I'm pretty sure, I'll have to check my notes, but Under will say the rules I made is not enough for a bonus point. It's basically, we kind of broke even. This here was an awesome fight. That was tooth and nail to the end. Alright, well, so we can go ahead and turn this sector over to Blue Control, and then... We'll give Red a chance to go ahead, or Opford a chance to go ahead and do, we'll say, an attack in the next mission. But anyways, if you like the content, would like to see more, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. If you didn't like it, leave it a thumbs down and get off my channel. Either way, let me know what you thought in the comment section. And until next time, I'd like to ask you all to game on.